Hey, I'm Rhana Paris. I'm one of the educators at the North Carolina Aquarium on Roanoke Island, and welcome to Star Party OBX. We're offering a series of virtual programs so you all can learn how to go out and do your own star parties. I'm working together with Coastal Studies Institute and Jockeys Ridge State Park to provide these videos for you. Today's video, what we're going to talk about today, is how to read a star chart. There's many ways that you can get a star chart. One is to get a sky wheel similar to this. These are kind of neat to have because they're good to have for a long period of time. But I want to show you why you might want to get a star chart from online. For example, you can get one from Google star charts online, and you can get a star chart similar to this. This one happens to be from Orion, but you can find one that gives you lots of good information. But the one I like to use is from Abrams Planetarium. It's Michigan State University's planetarium program, and I'd like to kind of show you how to use this star chart. For example, you'll see that it has a round circle on that. So what I want you to visualize is that we've taken the three-dimensional dome of the sky and smooshed it onto a two-dimensional piece of paper. So that's why it looks like a circle. You might notice that that dark line looks like trees and houses and such. That's showing you the horizon that is in your area. You'll also see four words, north, east, south, and west. And as you look at that, you might think, that must be a typographical error. But it's not, because they're assuming you're going to have this over your head as you're looking at the star chart. We're not going to bother with that right now. So north, east, south, and west, you'll get your north pointed in the direction where north is, where you are standing. For us here on the Outer Banks, figure out where the ocean is, and that'll be east. So make sure east is pointing toward the ocean. As you're looking at the star chart, you'll notice a bunch of dots. Those dots represent stars, and those dot sizes will represent the magnitude of the stars, how bright they appear to us here on the Outer Banks. Why I like to use a star chart that's good for each month specific to a year is that this chart will also show you things that aren't stars. For example, as we look in the east, there's going to be a very bright object indicated by a big star-shaped pattern. That's Venus. It's not a star. It's a planet, but we can see it in the night sky. So these dots represent stars that we can pretty much see in any part of the Outer Banks. They are grouped into constellations by dashes between the dots, and that gives us an idea which constellation we're working on. And you can see that they give the names of each constellation. You'll also see how this star chart will also kind of show you how to find other constellations within an area on this chart. So you'll see a little arrow from the Big Dipper that leads us on to the star we call Arcturus. Arcturus leads on to Spica and so forth. So you can use the star chart to be able to do a star party in your backyard and have your own Star Party OBX. Thanks for joining me. Look for another video on how to have your own star party. And remember to hashtag us, Star Party OBX, hashtag North Carolina Star Party.